Around 2.5 million years ago, during the Pleistocene epoch, a large cat stalked the grasslands and hillsides of North America. Thriving in a landscape not too dissimilar from the African plains of today, this feline lived with many magnificent beasts now lost to time, as well as animals that still live alongside us today. A head-scratcher to many paleontologists since its initial discovery, its identity and its impact on the Holocene wildlife has often been called into question. What was this enigmatic animal, and where did it fit into the greater felid family tree? This is the taxonomic oddity known as the American cheetah. The first findings of fossils belonging to the American cheetah were isolated teeth found at the Poor Kennedy Bone Cave in Pennsylvania. In 1895, famed paleontologist Edward Drinker Cope wrote the first description of the animal, classifying it as a North American relative to spotted hyenas, giving it the name Crocuta inexpectata. In 1899, Cope then reclassified it as Uncia inexpectata, believing it to be a relative of snow leopards, before the latter were reclassified into the Panthera genus with animals like lions and tigers. In the following decades, more fossil material of the American cheetah would be uncovered in Arkansas and Maryland. In 1941, paleontologist George Gaylord Simpson described them all as belonging to the same animal, reclassifying it as the species Felis inexpectata and as a close relative to the puma or cougar. More species would be described in the 60s, with a second species, Felis studeri, being described in 1960 by D.E. Savage, based on postcranial and cranial material found of the animal. A third species, Felis trumani, was described by Orr in 1969, based on a complete skull uncovered in Crypt Cave, Nevada. In 1979, Adams had found these fossils to be distinct enough from both pumas and Old World cheetahs to be grouped into their own distinct genus called Myrisononyx, a name meaning wonderful, unmovable claw. After the late 1970s, more fossils of Myrisononyx would be uncovered in various states such as Florida, Texas, Colorado, Georgia, South Carolina, and New Mexico. In regards to the described species, only M. trumani and M. inexpectatus are now considered as valid species, while M. studeri is considered a junior synonym to the latter. After this, we wouldn't have another significant breakthrough until the 2020s. This breakthrough is actually connected to a fossil discovery in 1936, in which bones and mummified tissue of four American cheetahs were uncovered, along with a saber-toothed cat, ground sloth, as well as vampire bats in the Grand Canyon's Rampart Cave. Initially identified as cougars, the discovery was left alone until John Paul Hodnett began to study the fossils back in 2019, eventually re-identifying the puma fossils as those of Myrisononyx trumani. The most distinct Myrisononyx specimens include a subadult and a 6-month-old cub. The bones of the subadult displayed several puncture wounds on the skull and spine, indicating a fight between two cheetahs, possibly a mother attempting to protect her cub from the subadult. This study was eventually published in 2022, giving us new insight into the American cheetah's behavior, appearance, and lifestyle. The final discovery came in 2022 of a Myrisononyx fossil in the Appalachian region. At the Berger Cave in southwest Virginia, 10 cavers and paleontologist Alex Hastings uncovered the near-complete skeleton of an American cheetah, naming the specimen Petra. Initially, Hastings believed that Petra was a 10,000-year-old jaguar, only to later conclude that she belonged to the species M. inexpectatus. American cheetahs were described as having short snouts and slim proportions similar to those of true cheetahs. However, the body type has been shown to be different depending on the species. M. inexpectatus might have been similar in appearance to cheetahs, while M. trumani has gone from being compared to cougars and snow leopards to recent studies now suggesting that it may have been more similar to lions. In general, American cheetahs are considered to be roughly similar in size to pumas while being larger than Afro-Eurasian cheetahs, weighing at approximately 70 kilograms or 156 pounds. In terms of body length, the American cheetah measures at 262 centimeters or 8.6 feet long and had a height of 8.5 centimeters or 2.75 feet. The family Felidae is currently composed of three recognized subfamilies: Lachyrodontinae, the saber-toothed cats, Pantherinae, big cats and their close relatives, and Felinae, purring cats. Myrisononyx belongs to the Felinae subfamily and is closely related to the puma lineage, with all three representatives belonging to their own respective genera: the cougar or mountain lion in the genus Puma, cheetahs in Acinonyx, and jaguarundis, not to be confused with actual jaguars, in Herpylurus. Despite their name and having some anatomical similarities to cheetahs, Neurocynonyx is considered to be a close relative to pumas rather than cheetahs based on genetic studies. In fact, when looking at Neurocynonyx and the puma lineage in their phylogenetic tree, both pumas and jaguarundis are genetically close to one another, while cheetahs are fairly distant from both Neurocynonyx and the latter two species. The puma lineage evolved around 8 to 5 million years ago in the late Miocene epoch, and branched off into the three existing genera, colonizing both North and South America. The puma genus, however, was not restricted to the Americas, with species such as Puma incurva being uncovered in South Africa, and P. pardoides, or the Eurasian puma, in Europe. It's now actually largely believed that cheetahs may have even migrated from North America to Africa and Eurasia through the Bering Land Bridge, hence why cheetahs are currently separated from their New World relatives. However, some paleontologists argue that the Acinonyx genus may have actually evolved in the Old World continents instead. Based on the locales in which fossils have been found, American cheetahs would have inhabited in a variety of different habitats that can be found in Pleistocene North America, from forests in the open plains to mountainous terrain, and judging by the findings in Pennsylvania, Arizona, and Virginia especially, Neurocynonyx may have frequently used caves and or cave systems for shelter. Fossil evidence also seems to suggest that American cheetahs were highly territorial, solitary animals that were prone to fighting each other, in stark contrast to modern-day cheetahs who are far more social animals, with males in particular often forming hunting parties. Given their range, they would have also been well accustomed to the shifting temperature depending on the seasons. Much like today, North America would have undergone months of intense heat, rainfall, and even harsh winters, during which much of the continent would end up coated in snow. Due to the Bering Land Bridge and the Great American Interchange, North America at this time was host to a great deal of biodiversity. Not only were most modern-day animals already present, but so were most of their extinct relatives, along with other animal groups that have since been lost to time. In terms of prey and hunting habits, however, this has long been the subject of debate. Neurocynonyx has been compared to pumas, the Asiatic cheetah subspecies, and even to the snow leopard based on the Rampart Cave findings, being described as a predator that was specialized in hunting more mountainous prey such as mountain goats and bighorn sheep. Originally, the American cheetah had long been hypothesized to be an avid hunter of one particular extant mammal, the pronghorn antelope, and its extinct relatives in the family Antilocapridae, such as the dwarf pronghorns Capromyrix, Tetramyrix, and Stachoceros, just to name a few. These New World relatives of the giraffe family are said to be the second fastest land animal after the cheetah, and paleontologists have long theorized that being hunted by the American cheetah is what led to pronghorns developing such incredible speed. This in turn led to the theory that Neurocynonyx underwent parallel evolution with true cheetahs, a phenomenon in which two different species evolve similar traits at the same time. According to recent studies, however, this is far from the case. Following isotopic studies, scientists have concluded that while Neurocynonyx did prey on pronghorns, they didn't hunt them exclusively or enough to warrant such a dramatic increase in the herbivore's speed. The most frequent predators to the pronghorn would have been wolves, cougars, and pantherine cats such as the American lion and jaguars. Modern-day cheetahs, especially those found in Asia, are capable of occupying mountainous and rocky terrain, but prefer inhabiting open plains and deserts. Another key difference that would have made the American cheetah incapable of hunting in a similar manner is their claws. Modern-day cheetahs possess semi-retractable claws to help them with maintaining better traction while sprinting after their prey. American cheetahs have been found to possess fully retractable claws much like other felids, which would have impacted their ability to pursue their prey in a similar manner. Far more recent studies, however, have come to contradict the notion of Neurocynonyx being snow leopard-like. A new study on the big cat's locomotion has shown that it may have been well adjusted to running on flat plains after all, but not to the same caliber as its namesake. Scientists have also found that Neurocynonyx might have also been capable of grappling its prey, a trait common among many cats except for, of course, the cheetah. This does not mean, however, that the American cheetah was incapable of thriving or hunting in mountainous habitats. As previously mentioned, cheetahs have been known to inhabit hillsides, as do pumas, and one particular subpopulation of lions, the Barbary lion, used to thrive in the Atlas Mountains of North Africa. The Rampart Cave findings may simply indicate instances of Neurocynonyx choosing a more elevated habitat, but like true cheetahs, they may have been more prominent in flat terrain. Other than mountain-dwelling grazers and the occasional pronghorn, American cheetahs may have also hunted various species of deer, potentially even modern-day elk and moose. The ancient horse, Equus scotti, North American llama relatives such as Paleolama and Hemiakinia, the Cope's tapir, and peccaries, along with smaller animals such as rabbits, hares, and a great variety of rodents as well. Several larger rodents were present in North America, such as the giant beaver Castoroides and Neocheirus, a North American relative of capybaras, and may have also fallen prey to Neurocynonyx. Herbivores that may have proven too big and too challenging for the American cheetah to hunt may have been bison such as the modern-day American plains bison, and its larger prehistoric relative such as the ancient bison and long-horned bison, along with the moose's relative, the stag moose, and the North American camelid, Camelops, or the western camel. However, Myrcinonyx could have occasionally targeted their young. The far larger ground sloths such as Megalonyx and the Shasta ground sloth would have also been safe from Myrcinonyx, as were the many massive proboscideans such as the Colombian mammoth and the American mastodon. Myrcinonyx's range was not without its fair share of competition either, as many predators were common during this time. While the smaller bobcats, foxes, and coyotes would have hardly posed a threat, the American cheetah would have had to contend with modern-day gray wolves, American black bears, grizzly bears, cougars, and jaguars, who were farther spread to the northwestern and midwestern parts of the United States during the Pleistocene epoch. Cougars and American cheetahs may have been the most frequent of competitors, especially due to occupying similar habitats and hunting similar prey. Among its more prehistoric competition would have included a unique and extinct genus of hyenas known as Chasma porthetes, along with dire wolves and Arctotis, better known as the short-faced bear. The continent was also populated by massive felids such as Smilodon, Homotherium, and the American lion, which was one of, if not the largest felid to have ever lived. The American cheetah has not appeared in a whole lot of media since its discovery, but it has made a single but brief appearance in the 2002 documentary series Wild New World or Prehistoric America, portrayed as a modern-day cheetah in episode 2 Canyonlands. The following year, it made another brief appearance in the documentary series Monsters We Met, where in episode 1, The Eternal Frontier, it was portrayed by a modern-day snow leopard. Unfortunately, these have been its only appearances in any form of media, but hopefully as it becomes more well-known, more media will start featuring this animal and provide it with its own distinct look, as opposed to simply using a modern-day big cat. The American cheetah went extinct with much of the Pleistocene megafauna approximately 13,000 to 10,000 years ago. The exact cause is currently unknown, but much like with the other animals it coexisted with, it may have been a combination of climate change and human impact. As of today, many of the animals that lived with Myrcinonyx during its time still exist today, but with a more fragmented distribution. Their close relative, the cougar, actually recolonized North America following the fifth mass extinction. However, it has since lost much of its range in the eastern United States. The American cheetah has also been the subject of many debates regarding Pleistocene rewilding, a controversial practice involving the introduction of non-native animals to regions where they'd replace their extinct contemporaries. Since 2005, it was proposed that modern-day cheetahs could be introduced into the Great Plains to replace the American cheetahs as the main hunter of pronghorns, but given everything we know about the American cheetah, they may prove to be an incompatible proxy. All in all, the American cheetah's presence in North America gives us insight into a unique ecosystem from a bygone age. It was a felid unlike anything that's been seen since the New World, mirroring the cats typically encountered in Afro-Eurasia. While more obscure than most of its contemporaries, it has itself a rich history within the paleontological community as an Ice Age predator whose identity and influence in the Great Plains has been debated since its initial discovery in the 1890s. This was the taxonomic oddity known as the American cheetah. Thank you all for watching today's video. We put a lot of work into this one and hope you enjoyed as much as we did. This video was directed and narrated by myself, Rango Gamer. It was scripted by myself along with The Primal Earth. The editors for this video were myself, Spinal Dragon Productions, The Primal Earth, and MikeMC9797. The graphic designers for this video were The Dinosaur Hunter for the thumbnail and the M. Trumani animation, and MephilisSaijin101 for the M. Inexpectatus animation. And lastly, the research team for this video was myself and Spinal Dragon Productions. Sources used for this video can be found in the description below if you'd like to check them out. Thank you for watching, and we will see you all in the next video.